Boy, what a way to be welcomed back by this sad, sad music. Well, hi guys. I forget what episode this is anymore, but we left off last time. Yeah, we left off last time. Sybil has just been murdered. Of all people, poor innocent little Sybil, who never did anything to anybody, except provide me with really important intelligence regarding who was going to die next and the movements and targets of Melzis' evil agents. So, yeah, we were just instructed to meet Septimus at Mira's house and dig through Maya's memories and see if we can't figure out whether she's friend or foe. So here's Septimus. And now it seems that Mira has sort of replaced Nadia with Maya. She refers to her as her darling. So she's kind of filling that hole in her heart that was left by Nadia's death now with Maya. Which is pretty sad in a whole lot of ways. Lose your nerve? You really just wish you were me, Septimus. You totally want to go rooting around in a cute girl's nightmare. Well, not nightmare, hopefully. But actually, I think this is one of the less irritating sequences in that I don't recall there being any enemies in Maya's dream. I think it's just puzzles. She's not buying it, Septimus. Boy, I'd really love to hear what kind of excuse he cooked up to talk to her about. All right. In we go. Let's see here. Naturally, she would be upstairs in the bedroom asleep. Whoops, clearly not there. There we go. Kids, don't do this in real life. You'll get into a shitload of trouble and probably get arrested. Boy, she snores like a chainsaw. Oh, well, this doesn't look so bad. I guess we're dealing with young Maya here. Of course, giving us the walk around. A nice... Yeah. We'll go with that. This whole scene is just dripping moe. Oni-chan, catch me! Oh god, that laugh. Alright, so I don't really remember this. God, but what kind of kid has moving platforms in their dreams? Actually, I shouldn't say that because I'm pretty sure I had at least one dream when I was a kid that had floating platforms. Probably the direct result of playing games like this. Oh well. Okay, a bunch of doors. This music, though, I love this music. Kohei Tanaka is a genius. Alright, okay, well, can't get there. Maybe over here. Yes, this appears to be something. I don't know why they would put a. Oh, okay. Oh, already? Cool. Hooray. Now I'll be less likely to die against the boss that isn't in this dream sequence. Okay. Oh, there she is. Found you! Ah, damn it. What the hell? Okay, well, if that was what I think it was, then I have a feeling, yup. She just ran off and blasted open one of these stone walls. Remind me not to mess with this kid. Oh, here are the puzzles. Alright. Alright, let's see. So, a stone statue of Maya. I don't know, guys. If any of my female viewers, because I know I have a few female viewers, I checked the analytics from my channel, and 5% of my viewers are female, which means that either 5% of you lied when you created your YouTube accounts, or girls really are watching. So if girls really are watching, ladies, do you dream about stuff like this at all, ever? Have you ever had a dream with floating platforms and statues of you and plants all around the outside edges and stuff like this? Wait, what? Okay. Oh, it's a warp pad. Oh, this looks dire. Ah, a statue of Melzus. Well, tragic past confirmed. So, I think for each one of these doors, we have to find Maya a separate time in each case. So, I think... Whoops. I think we're gonna have to... I think we're gonna have to just wander around. Oh, or not! Or she could be right there. Fine by me. Only in a dream would a little girl carry around dynamite and blast open walls. Okay, well, I'm assuming this is water. Yes, it is. Whoops. Well, I botched that. Damn it! There. So, I guess I have to... Wait, what? That didn't help. Yeah, no. That was no help. Oh, yes it was. Okay. Phew, there we go. It's not so much that the jumps are difficult, it's the sense of perspective in here that's been screwing me up. I'm just gonna cut out all those failed attempts, so there'll be a brief inconsistency there. Okay. Memory number 2. Let's see what we've got. Well, she's looking for a book of some kind, clearly. Which often happens to people who are a little bit too faithful and devout. Alright, well, that was interesting. Now if I could only get past these platforms. Whoops, oh well. Alright. It's time to play Where the Hell is Maya? Oh, interesting. Oh, and what's this? A gilded falcon. Boy, I sure am glad I didn't miss that. And a save room, it looks like, as well. Which is kind of pointless in this nightmare. Well, not even nightmare, but just dungeon. Because, there are no enemies. Aha! I should have guessed. Gotcha! Man, Maya sure loves that TNT. Oh, damn it. I was supposed to... There we are. Oh dear. Okay. We can't go left. So we must have to... Of course. Oops. Well, I screwed that up. Ha, got it. Okay. Well... Oh! Yikes. Alright. So, clearly I need this other torch. Oh, I see what I'm meant to do. Ah. Ooh, tea. Oh, boy. So I guess what happened was Maya's mother figured out that the god they were worshipping was really Melzus, and was apparently burned at stake for doing so. Well, that sucks. What can I say? Alright, where is the little brat now? Not here. I have a feeling she's probably over here somewhere now. You know, at this rate, I'm gonna die from dropping torches on myself, so might as well heal up. She's not over here. Well, that's good, I guess. We can rule this area out. Not over here. Is she down here? Yes, she is. How about that? I guess I'll just follow the explosions. Actually, it's up here, isn't it? This should be the one that opened. Nope. Oh no, it's the side one. The middle one looks more important, so this is probably the last one. And actually, I think I counted 7 doors, so the 3 on either side are probably the ones that... Yeah. I bet we're meant to go in the middle one last. Alright. There we are. Okay, what mischief awaits us this time? Okay. Oh, so I can't jump up there. That's too high. Alright, well, better start with what we can reach. Okay. Whoops. At least I don't have to leave the room to reset this one. I cannot tell. No, that's too high. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no? Oh, I bet I got it. I think I know what I'm supposed to do. Whoops. Damn it! The perspective. Ugh, I can't even tell how high that blasted thing is. It's the problem with a game like this. The art style is great, but there we go. I had a feeling it was something like that. It's just so hard to get a proper sense of perspective. What did this even do? I see exactly what it did. Ugh! Trolled! Okay. Alright. Well, I'm just gonna fast forward that, because that's a lot for you guys to have to sit through, so my apologies. Okay. I see her hiding in the bed. Aw, jeez. Run fast and far, Maya. Well, that's pretty sad. So I guess Maya lived in some sort of religious community with her mother, and then when her mother found out what was really going on, the shit hit the fan. As expected. Nice jump. Well, it would seem that she probably entered one of these doors. Yup. Yes, indeed. Oh. Okay. Fascinating. Oh, I think I know what's gonna happen here. I've gotta... Oh? Okay, then. I was kind of right, but it didn't quite work the way I expected. Oh, they really want you to stack three. Okay, I get it. There. All right. Ha. I don't suck quite as much as it looks like I do when I fast forward through stuff. Aha, so she just cured that guy of his nightmare. So now she finally understands what her mother figured out. And it's interesting because it almost makes it appear that the Elna, the Dreamwalkers, the clan that Maya and Alundra are from, were being hunted for their ability to cure the nightmares. Because I guess somebody decided to brand them as blasphemous. Aha! Oh, we get to see it! Oh no, no explosion! She just crashed right through the wall and went in! Alright, can I make this jump? No, I cannot! Great, well, now where does that leave me? Okay. Not really very helpful. I can't see where I am. Oh, okay. Well, that's irritating. Oh, I see. You had to fall in anyway. Alright, so... Figures. Alright, I get it. You have to save that platform until you get the torch. I see how it's supposed to go now. So you jump over here. You grab the torch. Oh, damn it. I should have seen that coming. Did it. Ah, and this brings us back to Enoa. Oh, and Melzis talks to her. Interesting. Or at least appears before her. So we've learned two very interesting things so far. The first is that Maya has the same mission as us. The second... Let's see if I can get... Ah, damn it. Oh, well. The second is that... Melzis apparently has already made himself manifest to her, so he knows she's out to get him. Alright, now I think we should just be able to go in that middle door now. Yup, she's right here waiting for us. Spy the guy? Guess I don't have much choice. I knew it. I knew it was going to be something like that. Okay. Oh! Oh, God! Oh, that's what these things are for. What? Hey! Damn it. So it's basically like red light, green light. Gotcha. Oh! Okay. Oh, I guess I'm done. Oh. Well, that's pretty simple, I suppose. Wait, what? Oh, that can't be good. Imps? Oh. Oh, okay, well... It looks like they opened up the waterway for me. Thanks for the info, Maya! Wow, Septimus, you kept her busy this whole time? What did you tell her? Yeah, perhaps I should. Weekly pedicure? Septimus! Wow. So we just peace out. Great. Yeah, let's team up with her. That's a great idea. Yeah, okay. Well, we're not quite at an hour yet, at least I don't think. My episode timer is meaningless now with all these fast forwards I'm gonna have to do, so I have no clue how long this is actually gonna be. Alright, what's going on here, Jess? Yeah, I've met him. He's a bit of a curmudgeon. Oh, now he wants to see me. Alright, well, I guess we should go pay Nava a visit. Oh, hi, guys! A pretty fairy at the pond, Interesting. Giant statue. Oh, interesting. Oh, that's, Nirud's lair. That they might be trying to hint to us that that's where we're supposed to go next. Oh, that sucks. Sorry, Keisha. Oh, and there's Giles at the altar, of course. Oh, Giles. You're so easily fooled. I'm gonna yoink your life gem. Yoink! Alright, oh, and I guess this is another opportunity to get into the secret room and get the secret pass. Bonair! Give me some interesting information! Well, that's what I'm here for. Oh, actually, you know what? I have 25 gilded falcons now. I think it might be worth paying Merrick a visit and seeing if I can pick up any of the interesting stuff that he has for sale. So let's go do that. And we'll deal with Nava later. I'm fairly sure Merrick's house is around here somewhere. No. Have I been in this archway yet? I don't remember. I still don't remember. Oh well. I guess Merrick's place is farther north. Oh, and actually, we can get the chests inside the water mill now. I could have sworn that you started up the machines with the wind scroll, but I guess I was completely and totally wrong about that. So in we go. See what nice treasures await in here. Money. A gilded falcon? Not bad. A strength tonic. Well, I guess it was worth it for the Gilded Falcon. Okay. Now back to Merrick. Cap'n! Yeah! Sounds fair. No prob, Captain. I'll hook you up. Yay! Thanks, Cap'n. I believe I can get the first three items with this number of falcons. I think. Yay! What is this? Oh, Olga's ring. I forget what it does. But it's probably pretty cool. Yay! Ooh! Thanks, Cap'n! Alright, let's see what this does. Increases attack power. Oh! Yes, please! Oh, you don't use it, it's just a, it appears to be a passive item. Actually, let's test this. There's gotta be an enemy somewhere. Well, we'll just head back towards Nava's cabin and test it there. I think that'll be the best thing to do. Alright, so how many hits does it take to kill one of these turtles? Three hits with the ring. Four hits without it. So, I guess it's a reasonable attack boost. It's like 33% if I'm doing my math correctly. Yeah, not bad. I guess I'll keep it on. Alright, what's going on here? Oh! Interesting. Nava summoned Maya too. Well, we'll deal with her later. Alright, Nava. What did you call me here for? What information network? You don't even talk to anybody! So those imps kinda did everybody a favor, really. The Gazek, huh? Interesting. So Nava knows stuff. Seems to know a lot more than he wanted to tell us up to this point in the game. So Nirud is a giant. Oh, and Melza stole his power. Hmm. Ah, so Nirud is potentially an ally then. Awesome! Well, having a giant on our side couldn't hurt. That would be pretty cool. Oh yes, and the spring bean! Awesome! This is excellent. This means that we can finally get into the... what do you call it? Yeah. Nava's not kidding, either. Nice. So in other words, what you're saying here, Nava, is that this plant... this plant can get me super high! Woohoo! Yay! Alright, well anyway, as I was saying, with the spring bean now in our possession, we can finally get into the Fire Manor, which will allow us to get our hands on the Fire Wand. And I believe with the Fire Wand, we can then get into the Ice Manor and get the Ice Wand. So I think, oh, and you know what? We have the Power Glove now, so I think that will allow us to get some other treasure as well. With the Power Glove, you can go get the Legend Sword if you've died at least 16 times, but I really feel like I don't want to cheese this game with the Legend Sword, because you can literally kill most bosses in a few hits with that sword. It's twice as powerful as the otherwise most powerful sword you get in the game, and you can get it way earlier. And you can totally bust the game with it, so I'm just going to hold off. I am going to see if I can go to the fairy pond yet, because we can get a better sword there. We can get the fairy sword. But I'm going to do that next time, because I want to wrap it up here. Also, I think what I'm going to do is, now that I have the spring bean, I'm just going to go gather a bunch of just random world map treasure off camera. I'm going to do the Fire Manor and the Ice Manor on camera, but... all the just random wandering around crap, I'm going to do off camera so that you guys don't have to watch me wander around and grab it. There's just a bunch of gilded falcons and money and other random stuff that's not really storyline important. So I'll do that off camera, and I guess I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for joining me. Woohoo! Tea!